All right, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. Fezzy, that's an Ichiban. And the reason why we call that is that means number one in Japanese. And that's maybe perhaps the number one story, the story everyone's talking about. Here's John. John, you're on Ron and Fez.
Almost say what?
What?
Again with that bit.
How about that game last night? Saints over the...
I just saw Pizza Joe just rolled in. Pizza Joe here early for the Thanksgiving. Joe, you sit over there and bring your cute friend. No, you sit there. Bring your cute friend in here next to me. Where were you at today?
We went out to breakfast at Clinton Street Baking Company.
No way to get that right. So what did you have for breakfast?
I had salmon and eggs.
Baked. Salmon and eggs, nice.
With this moldy grain bread, and I had parts of the other person's pancakes.
Oh,
and, maple butter.
From what I understand, the place is unbelievable. Was it?
Oh my God, it blew her minds.
Yeah, was your mind blown?
A bit.
Completely blown.
Yes.
All right. Well, it's good to see you. Oh, GVAX on line 8. It better not be.
Already?
I will get you, GVAX.
Why is this asshole in here?
I don't know what has happened over the years. Well, Dave, you know this better than anyone else.
Yeah.
But at some point in our career, the listeners stop liking each other. And the listeners decided what they hate most of all is other listeners.
Yeah. They everyone's jealous.
Now, does that happen to O&A also? Do their listeners hate each other? Or is this Ron and Fez?
I think it's a Ron and Fez phenomenon.
Mm-hmm.
I really do. Well, actually, I think a bunch of people hate that Paul, that no-filter Paul.
Really?
Yeah, he's very hated.
I met him. I thought he was delightful.
He's a nice English chap. I don't understand why people think he's so obnoxious.
Yeah. Here's Even Steven.
Hey, Ronnie B., you're a genius, buddy.
I was trying to tell Fez that earlier today, and he said it's just not true.
Hey, I'm tired of all this piss, watered-down beer in all the stadiums. You got to pay $9 for a cup of warm Schlitz. You know, they were to go back to like we done it here in my city here at the Brown Stadium. We just go big nickel beer night and then tear the seats out and throw batteries and all kinds of
stuff.
Yeah,
that ended that. They had nickel beer night there, and that ended it for stadiums all over. Of course, that and the Disco Sucks party in Chicago.
I thought that was the same night. Wasn't that
no.
the same?
No. Oh. Nickel beer took place in Cleveland, and it was some kind of doubleheader with cheap beer in Chicago during the big Disco Sucks
that Bill Vec
explosion.
That fucking crazy man. Putting midgets up at the plate. Disco, he was nuts.
But think of how many ball games took place that year. Nobody remembers one of them.
Yeah.
What's wrong with having a night that everybody's going to remember? What, are you stopping yourself from laughing?
Yeah.
What happens? They make fun of you for laughing?
No, she was making me giggle.
But one of the complaints about you stopping by is that you laugh too much.
I've seen that for years.
And that's because I do this at you. I'm going to get that baby. I'm going to get that baby. I'm going to get that baby. And then he just giggles away and laughs.
You can always make the baby smile.
Well, what are you going to do, Fezzy? You got to be there for the younger. I believe the children are our future.
Well, the word on the street about Sheepy is that...
Words on the street?
And yeah.
Okay.
And
written in sidewalk chalk.
Quote, unquote, he cackles like a pussy.
Oh.
And that was a quote from GBAC.
Well, I'll tell you this. I'm not going to tell you.
Please!
I was just going to say that the words of the prophets are written on the tenement walls.
Oh, God bless him.
866 Ron Zero Fez. Fez, you were saying that you were against people drinking what? You probably are part of what was known as the broken windows theory. Are you familiar with this at all?
I'm not sure what that is.
This is the theory that they actually started to turn New York around with. And the basic premise there was, if there is a neighborhood and the windows are broken in some of the old buildings, more crime will take place. And that's why they decided to come up with zero tolerance. And it happened, I forget who the police chief and who put it in under Rudy Giuliani, but that's when they got rid of the squeegee men, guys selling nickel bags of pot. They weren't worried about nickel bags of pot. But if you have that kind of shit, people will start and think, well, anything can go. you know, look, there's broken windows. Maybe I'll rape somebody. And so they started to fix windows, bust people from petty crimes, and they started to turn the city around block by block. Now, they were testing this somewhere over in Europe, and they found out if there's a neighborhood with graffiti, more people will steal bicycles than not. They would leave bicycles out in neighborhoods with no graffiti. Everything would be fine. Leave bicycles out with graffiti, they would disappear. So people will kind of float to their environment back and forth. What is it, Earl? You come running in here and you're mouth breathing.
It was under William Bratton. He was the police
commissioner. Thank you, William Bratton. You done now? You feel like you got your point? Here's what I'm going to keep you busy. I'll throw some pens on the floor.
Oh, they're everywhere. Can, you know,
dash over there.
Oh,
I call
mess.
It the not broken window, but keep a Negro busy thing that I have. If there's nothing for Earl to do, I'll just throw some pens down, and then he feels like he's getting his work done.
We should jot down your findings here.
Here is Tim. Tim, you're on Run of Fez.
Ron, you're killing me with Sheepy there. I thought there was a one-homo rule.
I'd see, now that's actually being rude to two of my friends. Dave, I apologize to you.
I'm not gay.
You know you shouldn't have to take that.
I have a child.
But it's not.
That's the worst thing you can say about a man.
Yeah, I know.
It is.
The worst. Wait. There's child rapist. No, gay is worse
probably,
than child
rapist. Probably worse. It's probably over that.
No, it is not.
Provided that child is a woman. A female. That's. But to get gay with a kid.
That's really fucked up.
That is. That's bad.
Being Jesus. Called gay
I
is not.
I should
because there's nothing wrong with it, Ron.
Oh, nothing's wrong with having sex with a baby.
No, I mean about being gay.
Oh, you're sick, Fez.
Child rapist
is
what's baby
there's
sex?
Nothing wrong with being gay. Child rapist is bad.
What's baby fucking? That's not going to pass in California.
No. I'm getting a petition now, and I'm trying to get people with me as part of this to ban the movie Milk.
This is going to be the best movie ever. I can't wait till this comes out next week.
Tomorrow.
I can't wait till the end. He calls tomorrow next week. Thank you. Thanks for doing Earl's job. Paul, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Almost as what?
I did it once today. You're going to have to keep up. I read RonFez.net. One per customer.
Oh, wait. Now they're running the show, RonFez.net?
No, but I agree with some opinions on there.
You can't go swinging back and forth with every thread that happens. Did you like the bit or didn't you like the bit?
Well, I liked the bit, but I mean, it's, you know, this guy's not being original. Someone already grabbed it today. Someone's already taken it.
All right. Fair enough. You got me.
I don't know if I like this one way. Either we're in or we're out. I can't have a once-a-day rule, and I can't have public opinion running the way we do the program here.
Yeah.
What's next? GVAX hour of blues talk?
Yeah.
If there gets to be a threat about that, do we have to put it out there?
It's like,
ladies and gentlemen, according to public opinion, here comes GVAX, and we're going to discuss the blues.
It's like taking advice from Dr. Joe K on RonFez.net.
I don't know who that is.
Oh, he's known as the cummiest member on RonFez.net.
What happens?
He's
then?
Just
How
really
do you win
cummy.
That?
He's just very cummy and sucky. I can't really provide you all the details.
Okay.
But let's just say I had a tip with him last night and I straightened him his ass out.
What happened there? Give me the insight.
He fucking hates my guts. Every single time I'm on and he keeps refreshing the Dave Fatigue thread. It's like the thread
well,
was
gone. Well, you know what?
Gone.
Now that Fez is going by threads... So am I. Get out. I have
no,
Dave
Ron!
Get out.
Come on.
Once a day you get to talk.
All this is bullshit.
All right, so the pressure's back on you now, Whatley.
Yeah.
Whatley, what was the greatest musical interlude between two bands? What do you got for us, Paul?
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to add to the broken window theory.
Well, once a day, Paul. Once a day.
I know. I know. I'm under
get out.
Here already.
Get unless there's a thread on RonFez.net that wants you back in. Yeah.
Can I come back in now, or
I'm gonna check with Third Tier, and if you're not a fan,
no,
I didn't know. What happens there? Is that where G-Back reigns supreme over you?
Yeah.
Here's Gio. You're on Ron Fez.
Chris says what?
Sorry, Gio, you missed it today.
I didn't say.
Brad, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, how you doing there? I gotta get your mom for today.
Let me play this. Go ahead.
I just wanted to
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I just wanted to say, just wanted to say, make fans real happy here. Florida, number one in children, teachers touching children in schools.
Yeah, they do really well there in wacky news. Florida has replaced California as being just the really strangest news to come out of.
The problem is it's just too warm there, even through the winter. People can't take it.
So when you get so hot, you feel the need to have sex with a child.
They go nuts there.
I don't believe that there is a temperature that would make me want to have sex with a child. This would act like... if everybody who goes into a steam room, you're sitting in there for 5 minutes and you're like this. You know, I got an idea. Let's go fuck a couple kids. I just don't believe this, Fez.
That's just a mess down there. They can't take it.
Brian, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hiya, boys.
Yeah.
I don't know, Sheepy. I don't know you all that well or whatever. I know you're on the show here and there. But I just wanted to know, do you have to constantly fake laugh at every little thing that is said throughout the whole entire show, every time you're on?
Yes. Why are you fake laughing? Obviously, the show's not very funny. Why are you fake laughing?
It's more of a cackle pussy.
What are you doing here? Didn't you get to the latest thread?
I'm out of
Dave
the room.
Fatigue. Do you got anything planned special for today, Dave? You got any kind of any of your bits?
Look, we're going to cook something up for you.
You don't have anything, do you? You don't do board gossip anymore?
I sort of had something, but... You know.
What was that, the cummy guy you were fighting with?
No, the other thing.
Here is the Daily Leader. Hello, Leader.
Hey, how's it going, Ron?
Nice.
I didn't want to be the one to break this to you, but there's a thread. There's no Ichibans allowed past 1 o'clock.
Okay. All right, so it's... I'm sorry. It's 104. This show does what the internet tells us. We are the show that listens intently to the internet.
I thought they had a good point in that thread.
What was that? What was the point?
About the what joke.
I don't even know the joke.
Someone calls in and says something derogatory very fast and then says that person says what and then I say what back.
Well, the way you say it, it sounds really funny. I haven't caught any of these. But the way you set it up, because I love to have a joke just peeled apart of anything at all. Just set up, just break it down like they used to with these sentences in English. And that makes humor funnier to me. I want to dissect jokes like they were frogs. What are you laughing? What are you fake laughing at now, Sheepy? Here is Dan. Dan, you're on Ron and Fez.
Best go back, watch, betting, fucking, faggot, cocksucker, say what?
You missed it, Dan.
Damn it!
You don't get it today.
Son of a bitch, Fez.
You don't feel like this stops everything right in its tracks? Whether you missed it?
I'm calling about freaking Sheepy, and I'm seconding the previous caller's freaking irritation with his faggoty-ass laugh. You can laugh like a man!
All right, here's the problem. The worst thing you can be called in this world is a fag. There is nothing worse. And, Dave, your brother's gay, right?
Yeah, he's gay.
Even he doesn't want to be called gay.
No, he doesn't want to be called that. No.
Why wouldn't he want to be called that? He writes for Queer Town.
Because he's,
sure.
He's smart.
But the sports column. He writes about soccer.
He actually had a picture with Joe Torre. I mean, not Joe Torre, Boa. The other day.
Boa's gay, huh? I didn't know. Larry Boa's gay. Now I call any gay act coaching third base. Here is Finn. Finn, you're on Ron and Fez.
Sorry, guys, says what?
I made an announcement earlier.
That was mine. He said, straight guy says what? I was ready to do my big what joke and yell out what, and then we could all laugh at me.
But, no, Fez, I heard that you aren't allowed to have secrets. That's what it said on the thread, so you got to tell your secret.
My secret will not be announced today. That's not going to happen.
What if a thread tells you to?
I will disagree with that thread.
Here is, here's Paul. Paul, you're on Fez.
Hey, guys. I just want to call about Sheepy again. A little Sheepy fatigue here. He used to, like, come on the air and bring, like, questions and scenarios and some
outside. All right, well, why don't we let, all right, let's let him do that. What's on your mind today, Sheepy? What's, in your crawl?
The shows that got canceled, all the shows that got canceled this year, they just announced, they canceled Pushing Up Daisies. It's one of my favorite shows.
All right, great question. So your question is, they canceled Pushing Up Daisies. Now, I will admit this to you. Not only have I not seen this, I don't seem to have shows anymore. I remember being a guy who had shows. I don't know what's happened to all my shows, because I don't even know if they got canceled. I just don't, I've almost given up TV.
The writer's strike hit everything.
Is that it?
Yeah. The everything took a hit with, they didn't know where the plots went, and they all cut their stuff short last year, and then they tried to rush with that extra bit.
And now they're going to do an actor's strike.
Yeah, that seems like it's totally happening, too.
But my thing is this. I think, I don't care if the actors strike, as long as the writers get out and get on film and just read it. Here's what would have happened.
Table reads.
Yeah, it's a table reads, but with the writers. And it'll be like this. And then there's a big explosion, and it's the fire is chasing Bruce, and then he gets away with it by diving through a door. This happens all the time in film, and I don't know if once in recorded history any man's ever outrun a fire. Just an explosion, and you turn around and you see it coming.
It's always up an elevator too, and then goes down a hallway.
Yeah, they
follow you.
And I think about that every time I'm on an elevator. What if there's an explosion at the bottom and just a big fireball coming up here? Where can I dive? Because it doesn't get anyone. They do manage to get away from it. Ed, you're on the Ron and Fez show. Ed, how are you?
I had a guy call up and use the word frickin' 3 times in his phone call and have the nerve to tell Sheepy to be a man.
Good one. Good one, Ed. What else is on your mind today, Sheepy? What else has just got... You used to come in with, like, little questions. Brain teasers, little mind benders.
I usually read a bunch of newspapers beforehand. And come with a whole list of things.
But today you went out to breakfast.
Yeah, at the Clinton Street Baking Company. It was great.
You had that written down?
I got a postcard.
Why don't you bring me a little snack from there?
I got,
see the postcard.
I got, okay.
What'd you get me?
Got biscuits and maple butter.
Bring one in. What are we waiting
for? All
right,
hold on.
Here's a pie plus a biscuit equals happiness. Thanksgiving to go.
Pie biscuits.
I was in this argument the other night whether pie is a northern thing or a southern thing. And we went round and round over it. This is the famous apple butter?
Maple butter.
Maple butter. I've never even heard of maple butter. Was this supposed to be for the big celebration later?
Sort of. But
I'm just going to have one before the celebration.
It was so good that you got to just try it as soon as possible.
Look at the size of that biscuit, too.
Those biscuits are huge.
I'd put a burger on that.
The syrupness, the person I was eating with, she took one bite and she slammed the table. She was just pounding.
She bit her tongue?
You know what? That's obsessive. To be that into food?
She turned beet red. I've never seen her blush ever.
I have.
And she just went crazy. I think she's syrup drunk.
Wow.
Isn't it amazing?
That is a strange taste. Only because it's butter, but it's more like almost like it's an icing.
That's
sick.
It's just so.
It does look like it has like a syrup texture to it, though.
It must. I mean, we didn't ask any questions of how they make it, but it must be from scratch, and they just mix up their blend. They've won this. Clinton Street Baking Company has won Time Out Awards for best breakfast and brunch in Manhattan. It was so good.
What did you buy into the place? let's go over here to John. John, you're on Fez.
Hey, how you doing? Yeah. Fat Mac says what?
You missed it today, John. Sorry.
No prize closet.
Nothing for you, John. Nothing on this Thanksgiving week.
Come on, Fez. Talk to you later.
Bye, John. This is like liquid candy, this is butter.
It's John, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, cackle pussy says what?
Like I told the other John, oh, sorry, one for customer today.
That was for Sheepy.
Oh. Go ahead, Sheepy.
Not only have you...
What show?
Not only have you cock-blocked yourself, you're now cock-blocking me and Sheepy from having fun things to say what, though. We can't say what anymore. All that internet, it's changed everything. Come on back in here, Davey Mac. You and your stink shirt.
Yes!
What little bit do you have for us? What do you got?
Oh!
Which one of your bits is ready today?
Oh!
One of your funny characters? Whatever happened to your what do you call it, the clown guy?
Fuck twat.
Whatever became of fuck twat.
I don't recall. He just died.
He died. We'll take a break. It's right. Fez, I saw this report out. Scientists think that once they're able to clone a woolly mammoth, which is an odd thing just to say once. Once we get woolly mammoth, Neanderthals would also be possible. That's kind of exciting.
Yeah, it's exciting, I guess, that they can do it, but I don't think scientists should clone a Neanderthal.
Why not?
They should absolutely, because here's the thing, you're not getting a Neanderthal. You're getting...
Yes, you are.
You're not getting a caveman. You're getting a subhuman species that is in today's world. You're not going to get a Neanderthal that does Neanderthal things. You're basically...
Sure it will. It will be. And all these things are subhuman. I mean, if you look at a rabbit, it's a subhuman.
Yeah, but with the Neanderthal, that's like a person. It's a different type of person. It's a different kind of human.
I don't really even think it's a human. It's a Neanderthal, right?
Oh, I thought it was still like some sort of human subset.
I think it's still in the genus, the human genus.
All right, so it would be considered, but just a little different.
Right, it's a different kind of human.
I think there's a chromosome difference besides the skull shape and body shape.
So basically what you're doing is cloning like a Down syndrome kid or something.
Not really. You're bringing back a perfectly working Neanderthal. What I find absolutely exciting about this, it means that nothing is ever extinct. Nothing goes away. We can keep it all. And the first thing I like to do is get all these things on slides like they always do on those Dexter slides. Get a bunch of them, put it in a spaceship, and shoot it into space. And maybe there's a way that some alien creature out there will find it one day and pop up his own little Earth wherever he happens to live.
Plus, the good thing about cloning Neanderthals is we could do experiments on them. In other words, they could be like a guinea pig for us.
Well, I don't know. I mean, to me, I'm against it. You know, you don't know that. Now, I would let them pull wagons. I would mind having right. 12 of them and have them pull wagons.
See, you're bringing in something that's super strong and super unintelligent.
How do we know until we get it here?
They're not even sure it can talk. They're going to try to teach it to talk if they can clone one.
Grunting's fine. Grunting is plenty.
They'll be very useful. I mean, we could harvest their organs. They're fucking
organs. I want my own human cloned organ.
Giant.
But I think it's just exciting that nothing now leaves the planet. We'd be able to bring everything back, which means let's hunt our fucking asses off. Let's shoot every goddamn rhino out there. There's always going to be more. We can now start and bring things back just to hunt them. I would love to hunt a Neanderthal. I think it would be fabulous. Just to fucking see it going up over the mountain.
They're tough,
have a scope
though.
And just blow the top of his big thick head off.
But they're very good at scurrying.
Yeah, I know. It's not going to be easy. But I'm going to fucking shoot the fuckers out of a goddamn biplane. And biplane is one of the worst things you can call plane.
Sucky. It's fine.
Chris, you're on Ron Fez.
Yeah, aren't gay people subhuman?
Yes. Here's what I really worry about with the cloning, is one of the reasons I'm against it. Gay people will now be able to reproduce. Now, they can't marry, but they would be able to reproduce, so we would have bastard gays.
Oh, jeez.
Wait a minute, this is the greatest name for a band ever. The bastard gays? What are we waiting for?
It wouldn't be a horrible thing if gay people could have children. They would still love their children. It would be the same as anyone else having a child.
That's the way they love their children. Sexually.
Suck their cocks.
All right. Well, you know what?
What?
Bluntness can ruin everything.
Okay.
I like a subtleness there. Here's Ivan. Ivan, you're on Fez.
Yes, hi. Hey, Fez, why are you being so negative if you're the clone of a buffalo?
Very nice. Very well put, too. I think they've cloned the Neanderthals and given them our phone number.
What if you found out you were the clone of Paul Lynde? Would that be the most exciting thing ever?
I would never stop jumping up and down clapping for myself.
Or your boyhood idol, Alan Seuss, who I'm not sure if anyone even remembers.
From Laughing.
Hi, guy.
Big Al Sports.
So you used to watch him on TV?
Oh, I always watched Alan Seuss.
How old are you? A million?
And Paul Lynde.
A million years old?
I am not a million. Not time to start cloning me.
Are you afraid of Neanderthals because you used to see them around school when you were younger? Here's Toby, you're on Manifest.
All right, 16582, my buddy.
What do you say, buddy?
Believe gays should have the right to get married, say what?
He doesn't do it anymore. No is the funniest phrase you can have in comedy. What you want to do is stop any bit. Here is Tim. Tim, you're on Manifest.
Hey, what's going on, buddy?
Yeah.
Fez, I got to call you out on something, but I'm usually on your side. But today I got to say, you're saying one per caller. So if one per caller gets a what, then you're not going on your own thing.
Then it would be every caller.
Hmm. Yeah, so he's got to stick with the bit.
Oh, I see what you're saying. I meant to say one per day. Sorry.
Yep.
I'm an idiot.
What about people that don't listen to the whole show?
They should be listening to the whole show.
Even I don't listen to the whole show, and I'm in here. That's why I can't wear headphones. I keep hearing the show in my ears.
Oh.
Why you gotta wear the stink shirt
Fuck
every em. Day? Is that your new bit?
With the people.
Your new character that you're Fuck working em. On? Oh, here comes Fuck 'em. Wonder what he's upset about today.
This steak sandwich sucks. Fuck 'em.
Why are you going to bring up steak sandwiches?
I don't like those Los Angeles Angels. Fuck them.
Well, why couldn't you bring up a goddamn food group that we that we could get around here? Not one that we can't. And no, I ain't going to one of these fucking Philly knockoffs cheesesteak places in New York.
Oh, we went one time. It wasn't good.
Well, it's not good.
No, it sucked.
By the way, when I was
right by Bar 9.
Philly the other day. Jacob, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hi, Ron. Do you think a little Neanderthal baby would taste good?
I think they would be stringy. You know, I know that you worry about this stuff, but we just found a new species the other day. And this is as deep in the ocean as we've ever been. I've already sent it to you. It is a fucking long squid, right? Like a jellyfish, but it has elbows. And you
really?
See the elbows go out and the tentacles just hang down. And I mean, they go down like 30 feet or something. Jesus. Here's what kills me about us. If we know what something is, we stop calling it a monster. There are monsters all over this planet that we're acting like, well, that's just an aardvark. It's no big deal. A fucking aardvark is a monster. And it should be hunted down and killed and then later cloned.
I had one professor in college.
Hold on. Fez, there's three gay guys there that said they want. This is going to be your version of the dating game. Look at the size of these guys.
They're all a little too burly, really.
You know what's stuck in my head? Homeless. Homeless. I can't get out of my head now.
So good.
That song?
The whole album. Fuck him. He made a masterpiece with that thing.
Here's Jack. Jack, you're on Fez.
Fezzy, you ought to be really comfortable because it sounds like there's a gay fag in the room with you.
Jeez. I mean, he's right, but jeez.
It's the worst thing you ever say about a man. That's the very worst.
There are worse things you can say,
Name
and
one.
That is not a
Name
bad
one.
Thing.
Name one.
You could call someone, you know, a liar and a thief.
I'll take that any day of the week. Matter of fact, you can say that to me, and I would answer, a present. That's how comfortable I am with that. Here is Marvin. Marvin, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, I was just wondering if they... Like the Neanderthal, what are the chances it looks like Paul's grandma?
See ya.
All right, first of all, let me just say this. If we do clone one of these things, they will rise above Erwin status in no time. So this is it, Fez. You're done with it? That was what you had to say about the Neanderthals? You don't want them?
I do not want them.
All right. Here is Joey. Joey, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, fellas, you sound like $1 million.
Well, I feel like $1.380. I'm not going to lie to you.
I got a question for Earl. What if we cloned a bunch of Neanderthals? And could we turn them into slaves to do all our...
Would you have any problem with that, Earl?
I would have a big problem with that.
Why?
Absolutely have a big problem
with
that.
What if they were white Neanderthals?
Like John Elway.
Sure. Would you turn them into quarterbacks? Would you have them do our bidding on football fields? Go ahead, slave. Lead that offense down the field.
Don't forget to pick up the blitz. Football players,
he never
yes.
did.
Slaves, no.
That fucking guy can play in pocket. If anything, I had a nickname for him. It was Brass in Pocket.
I'm like, what is Earl talking about? The quarterback doesn't pick up the blitz. It's the running back's job or
he's
the halfback.
Putting on the blitz is what he's saying.
What the fuck?
He means to know the blitz is coming.
But that's totally different.
Earl's fucking thing is, oh, there's a blitz. Let me just chuck the ball.
Different lingo, though.
He thinks he's Donovan McNabb.
See, but the thing is, if we create these Neanderthals, fuck, we are their own. We're their masters. Yes, we can.
We're
do
the masters of everything on this planet.
Yeah, I'm a total believer in that, and we own them. We can do whatever the fuck we want with those Neanderthals.
I don't want to come across as sounding racist here, but the best thing that's ever happened to this planet is the Caucasian heterosexual male. And right. That is the prime spot.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot to mention Christian. So it's the Caucasian, Christian, heterosexual male.
4 for 4.
You talk about hitting a lottery at birth. They ought to have a fucking slot machine fucking sound every time one of those kids is born. Because the earth is just yours from that point on.
It's so great.
Yes.
It's just the best. Being straight and white.
Who? Yes, there they are up there. Who has fucked up more than me and Dave, and there's nowhere we can't go? I mean, I've lived my life like a Cossack, and I was more than accepted at the Ritz the other day. Right this way, Mr. Bennington.
Yeah, we get respect like that.
Yeah.
Mr. Mr. Bennington. That's why I call you Mr. B, because you're white and you're straight.
I didn't know that was the reason.
Oh, yeah.
I like to call it Born Hannity. It's like you have just dropped out like a baby Sean Hannity. Here's Trip. Trip, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, love you. Love the show.
Oh.
Are we going to be able to clone buffalo backs if we can have all this technology?
Yes, we would be able to clone anything we want. Would you yourself want to be cloned?
Oh, yeah.
Would you want to have your clone after you're dead?
Yeah, I would want to be cloned.
It won't be you, though.
Oh.
How could it be you?
Well, it would look like me, and I'm sure it would
have... So, if you had a twin brother, that would be you?
No, it wouldn't be me, but it would probably...
When you're dying, you look over at your twin brother and go like this, at least I'm still alive. Yes, your clone will not be you. It'll be a clone.
Still, you know, you can have someone to hang out with. I'd love to have a me, so maybe we could start a band or something.
If I told you this, if you had a clone... You would hate you as much as I do. When
that's
you
not true.
See how annoying it is to keep you under control, you will despise your clone. And you will say, this clone is the biggest dick I've ever met. Why can't he fucking handle his own liquor?
I would love my clone.
And then you'll do this at your clone.
Hey, come on.
You'll just be chucking things at your clone.
You would be so jealous of your own clone, Dave.
I wouldn't be
You would jealous. Hate another Dave around. You would compete
with
him.
No.
I bet even if you had a clone. That looked exactly like you, its dick would still be bigger.
Oh, that's impossible.
Because I don't think that could happen twice.
No.
I don't think it could happen twice
Please.
In the history of the world. Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, buddies. BAC276 checking in.
How are you, my friend?
Okay. Ron, I want to, if you don't mind, I'd like to add to what you said about growing up as a heterosexual white male in America.
Yeah.
You got to add in that it's the Northeast. Because who's paying attention to anybody in Oklahoma?
Yeah, very good point. So the Northeastern white.
Yes.
I'm really just trying to get it down to me. But there are lucky breaks. I mean, when you think how many species are on the planet, and then you get to be a human, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then when you think, all right, so top of the food chain right away. Then how much of this fucking planet could you be born a fucking human on, and you end up in the United States? Boom. Then you're like, fuck, this is going great for me. Then you find out, uh-oh, I look down, cock and balls. That moves me immediately above 50%. Then you look over, white, boom, I'm now up into the top percentile. It's almost like you've been born on a jet ski, just whipping through life. No! Hey, are you going to study? Don't need to! Look at my white balls! I'm American! It's just the fucking easiest thing that could ever happen to a human. And then at some certain point, you're going to say to yourself, I'm sad. Why? All you've been given is blessing after blessing after blessing. You could have been born a gay, Jewish, black slug in China. Just think.
Like Sammy Davis Jr.
No, that's so far away from being the truth.
Oh. So awesome being white.
It's the best.
It's so great.
It's the best. And now that we're not going to worry about the presidency anymore. Oh, yeah. God, that's great. Now we got some. We finally did what we set out to do. Let the black people take care of the government for us. Let the black people worry about that. We're laying out next to the pool.
And when you're
four
white,
years off.
When you're white, you know, you can just buy a nice pair of pants that fits. And, you know, you don't have to worry about all these accessories the way blacks do.
Chris, you're on Fez.
I'm thinking if we can take a Neanderthal and clone a few of them, they could be producers for the Ron and Fez show and, you know, get things done. Be like,
are we cloning phone calls so they're the same one coming in time yeah. after time? Joey, my pal Joey, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I got a quandary for you. What if we cloned the Neanderthals? They did all our work, but it turns out the reason they went extinct is because they were all gay.
Here is Doug. Doug, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey.
Terrible calls.
If you clone yourself and you fuck yourself, would that be masturbation?
Well, let me ask you this. If you fucked your twin, is that masturbation? Or are you a twin fucker?
If you're,
I think you're a twin fucker.
If you're a clone fucker if you stick your cock in his ass. But if you just jerk him off, that's fine. That's totally fine.
Why is his ass different from his dick?
Why are you so lazy you can't jerk yourself off? You gotta bring a clone.
It's got another pair of hands. Another pair of hands.
If I lost both my fucking arms, I'd figure out some way of jacking my fucking...
Because I'm always like clicking on the computer and stuff. So that would just be great if I'm clicking on the computer and maybe have some a sandwich or something.
You're multitasking.
You just want extra arms.
Yeah, you don't need the whole clone.
If we have cloning technology, can we have extra arms?
Here is Anthony. Anthony, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, hey, buddies. Fez, I was just wondering, when you go to Florida, do you stay in your old bedroom, or do you get, like, a nice hotel room and rent a car and stuff, or you just sit home with your parents?
No, I stay in my old room.
And then they pick you up at the airport.
Right.
And then you also say that they make you do chores.
Oh, yeah, then they'll want me to, like, clean up the house for Thanksgiving before all the company comes.
Do you ever say, I'm the fucking company?
I've tried to explain that. They don't seem to understand.
Maybe it's because you're down there freewheeling. You don't even think to yourself, I'll show up and help. Sawyer. Today's Tom Sawyer. You're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up? Would somebody please tell Sheepy to quit fucking laughing? I think I'd rather listen to fucking Dave show on Saturday night than to hear that shit anymore.
Well, that's the worst thing you ever said.
No. Special Delivery is a brilliant show.
SD?
Yeah, SD Jones, baby. Taking the world by storm. There's going to be a special announcement soon.
When are you delivering that?
I'm not sure. I haven't gotten the official clearance. I'll have to talk to my partner, Sam.
Here's G-Man. You're on Ron and Fez.
Dakota 1229. Hey, Fez, after you're done with this turkey trot, I don't think they'll be calling it a 5K anymore. More like a 5-gay.
He doesn't do that. Once a day. Once a day. Or once a gay.
Fez likes the Tagay show every morning.
There would be nothing wrong with a Tagay show if someone wanted to put it on the air, broadcast that in the mornings on NBC.
Big gay. Big gay. No longer wants to do the what gimmick. Big gay.
Fez in Chinatown loved Faye Dunagay.
He fills up his dildo with double gay batteries.
favorite chef is Bobby Gay.
Gay.
Right. Gay.
Bobby Gay. Gay. Bobby Gay would have done it.
That one isn't even hard to do. You maniac loser.
K. Sera Sera says Doris Gay.
Good Time starring Gay Gay Walker.
I understand. I get okay, it.
Favorite right. bird?
The blue gay. Gay.
Bill, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Hey, boys. Hey, I just got back in the truck, and I just heard the end of this. Did Fez say after eating turkey he was going to be stuck in a portalette with the trots?
Zoo Nation, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Dick Holder, 7898.
Hello, sir.
Hey, Fez, I just want you to tell me, what does cum taste like?
Ask your dad.
Oh!
Here's Jay, or as I should say, Gay, on the Ronnie Fez show.
When Fezzy cooks crabs, he uses Old Gay.
Old Gay! Gay. That's, by the way, a spice used on the Eastern Shore.
What is a portalette, exactly?
That's a shit house that they, you know, that's portable.
Oh, okay.
Portable like, toilets.
Porta-Johnny. We call them Porta-Johnnies.
Johnny on the spot.
Who cares what you call them? It's just a fucking yeah. shit house.
I didn't know what a portalette
call it
was.
Any fucking name you want to call it. It's a traveling shit house.
Confused.
You probably used to call it a fucking summer home.
That
yes,
happened.
We're staying here at down the beach.
There's toilet paper in here and everything, Dad.
I wonder if a construction worker has ever flushed a toilet in his life. They probably have no idea there are permanent toilets that can be flushed.
They got to be shocked that the water's not blue in all of them.
Yeah. Some guy took a big shit on the bus this morning. Like when he gets
That's
on
disgusting.
The bus, everyone was like, are you fucking kidding me, pal?
Was there even a toilet on it?
Yeah.
Here is Mike, you're running fast.
Yeah, like Sinatra, Fez likes to do it my gay.
Real Purple, you're on Fez.
Hey, Fez is your favorite 007 movie, Die Another Gay.
Here's Kevin. Kevin, you're on Fez.
Fez likes to go sailing in San Francisco, gay.
Alex, you're on Fez.
Hey, I wanted to ask Fezzy, what's your favorite late night show? Is it Late Night with Gay Leno?
That was the last thing. We have a new rule here. One a day. One a day. We don't care what we got to do as long as it's only once a day. Here is Pat. Pat, you're on Fez.
Homer say what?
We don't do that anymore. The answer is no. And because right. of that, I'm getting rid of your call. I'm right, getting rid of your call. We're going to break because this is really...
It's awful.
Yeah, well, we went through these other slices so fucking fast. I don't know what to do next. So we'll break. Run a Fez show.